CIET-NCERT presents curriculum-based series Dhwani Shala. So, let's join in Dhwani Shala, Class 3.
Hello, my dear children. How are you all? I am Pooja Rana, your math teacher. I am back today with lots of activities and fun games. First of all, you tell me, do you remember the topic that we did in the last episode? I hope you must have done the activity as well at home. We did chapter 1, Where to Look from Math Magic Book of Grade 3. In the last session, we learned many different views of an object. We tried to visualize the object, mainly three sides. We tried to visualize the object from mainly three sides: front view, side view, and top view. We also observed the reason behind these different looks of the same object. So children, today we will complete this chapter and we will learn one more very interesting topic from chapter 1. Today we will complete the chapter 1 and learn many interesting things. We will do many activities and fun games too. So, are you all ready? Yes, let us start our topic today. Hey kids, I have a story to tell you. Do you like stories? Yes, I knew it. Even I like stories. So, this story name is Tit for Tat. Do you know the meaning of tit for tat? Okay, we will come to know the meaning of this title. One day, Amina met a painter. Amina asked to the painter, "Can you make my picture?" Painter replied, "Yes, sure. I charge rupees 200 for it." After a while, the painter showed her the picture. He asked Amina, "Amina, how do you like it?" Amina was confused and said, "But this is only half." The painter replied, "The other half is exactly the same. So, just put a mirror to get the complete picture. Now, can I have my money?" After thinking for a while, Amina gave him a 100-rupee note. Painter said, "But this is only half the money." Amina replied, "The other half is exactly the same. So, just put a mirror next to the note to get the full money. Ha ha ha." So children, do you like this story? I'm sure that you had enjoyed the story a lot. Now, I have some questions for you. So, are you ready? Okay. Now tell me, the painter made half picture of Amina. Can you visualize your half picture? Which and how many body parts will be visible in your half painting? try to visualize and think. Okay, let us think together. First of all, we will start from the head to the toe. So, in my half painting, my only half head, half forehead, one eye, half nose, half mouth, and half chin can be seen. Half body like only one hand and one leg and half body can be seen only. So, what do you think? Can this half painting become complete after putting the mirror with it? Think over it. Yes, it will become a complete painting when we will put a mirror next to it. Okay, now tell me, how will you put the mirror to see the complete painting? Think over it. Yes, we will have to put the mirror vertically just next to the half painting. Then we will able to see the complete painting. Now tell me, Amina gave 100 rupee note to the painter. So how will it become 200 rupee by putting mirror next to it? Think over it and discuss it with your elders. So, the painter in the story used to make only half paintings or drawings which can be seen completely only after putting mirror next to them. He had made few more half paintings of many objects, like he made half butterfly. He also made half diya, half face mask, and half star. Even he made a half painting of fish. Children, if you have textbook with you, you can have a look at the paintings given in the book. But if you don't have textbook with you, then you may try to draw half paintings of a butterfly, a diya, face mask, star, and fish. It will be great fun. Now, you will have to put a mirror next to the painting and you will be able to see the complete picture. Isn't it fun? Yes, I found it very funny and very interesting too. Okay, this painter's trick seems to be an amazing game. So, let us try to think and draw some more shapes or objects which can be drawn with this trick. Can we repeat the painter's trick for all the objects or all the designs? Let us take some more examples. Think of a caterpillar. Think of a cup. And think of a flag. Now, tell me whether a caterpillar can be divided into two equal halves. Think over it. No, na? Okay. Can a mug be divided into two equal halves? The answer is again no. Can a flag be divided into two equal halves? Again, the answer is no. We cannot divide each and everything, every shape or object into two equal halves. Now, what does this two equal halves means? The painter's trick is based on the concept of mirror halves. Children, now let us understand the term mirror halves. The half painting of Amina is an example of mirror half. Amina was able to see her complete painting by putting mirror next to it. So, such shapes which can be divided into two equal halves are called mirror halves. Okay, children, let us understand it one more example. You all must have seen the picture of Taj Mahal. Imagine the Taj Mahal. The image will come in your mind. If we draw a vertical line in the middle of this picture, will it be divided into two similar equal parts? Yes, it will be divided into two equal halves. So, it is an example of mirror half. Now, take a square or rectangle shaped paper from your notebook, or you can take any waste paper and fold it from the middle. Now, make a good tight crease on the joint folded part of the paper. Now, unfold it. You can see a straight line on the paper, which is dividing the paper into two similar rectangles. This image is an example of mirror half, and the line is called the line of symmetry. Now it's activity time. Now it's time to understand the mirror halves and line of symmetry. You might be thinking, oh, these terms are too difficult. What is this line of symmetry? What is this mirror half? Tell me, children, how many of you help your parents in the household work? Have you ever tried to fold your clothes? Some of you might have done it, or some of you might not have done it. But in this activity, we all are going to fold our clothes. Let us take a trouser. Now, tell me, how will you fold it? Yes, we will flip the one leg of the trouser onto the other leg. So, this first fold is the line of symmetry, which is dividing the trouser into two similar halves, or we can say mirror halves. So now tell me, what is the shape of pizza? Yes, a complete pizza is of circular shape. But when we have to eat it or serve it, then we have to cut it into pieces. First, vertical cut make it mirror half. When we get a piece of pizza to eat, its shape is triangular. So, can you divide this pizza piece into mirror halves? Think and tell me. Yes, again this piece of pizza can be divided into two equal similar halves. by cutting it from one corner to the middle of the opposite side. Children, I have used some new terms, which are symmetry, mirror halves, and line of symmetry. Before going further, it is important to understand these terms. So, let us discuss these new terms one more time. First word which I used is symmetry. Children, symmetry means that one part of the shape becomes exactly like the other part when we move it in one way, when we turn it or flip it or slide it. For two objects to be symmetrical, they must be of same shape and size. For example, you must have seen flip cover for the mobile phones. How many of you have that cover? Maybe your parents might have flip cover for the mobile phone. So, this flip cover is the example of symmetry. One side of the cover is symmetrical to the other side of the cover. As we have discussed it earlier as well, mirror halves divide a figure or a design into two similar halves that are mirror images. For example, double door of our classroom is an example of mirror halves. Is there a double door in your classroom? Think. Yes, it is the example of mirror half. Now, we will discuss line of symmetry. The line that divide a figure into two similar parts or halves, that line is known as line of symmetry. For example, take your notebook or book. When you open it, the middle line by which two pages are joined can be defined as line of symmetry. So children, I hope you understand these terms much better. Dear children, now we will try to make mirror halves of some images. If you have textbook Math Magic, then you can open page number 9. But if you do not have textbook, no worries at all. After all, I am here to describe you the pictures. There are 3 pictures of a triangle, and each triangle is divided by a dotted line. In the first 2 triangles, the dotted line is starting from the middle of a corner and going straight to the midpoint of the opposite side of that corner. Children, I repeat it again. In the first 2 triangles, the dotted line is starting from the middle of a corner and going straight to the midpoint of the opposite side of that corner. Now, if we look carefully at these pictures, we can see that the dotted line is dividing the triangle into 2 similar parts. If we fold this triangle from the dotted line, the one part will overlap the other part. So, this dotted line is line of symmetry. And this image is the example of mirror halves. But if we look at the third triangle, in the third triangle, the dotted line starting from the middle of one line and going straight to the middle of opposite line. So, the two parts formed by this line are not equal at all, or they are not similar. So, in this exercise, many images are given with dotted lines, and you have to tell that does the dotted line divide each picture into two similar mirror halves or not. Children, now we will take example of shapes and pictures one by one and figure out that whether they are mirror halves images or not. So let us take an example of a comb. Think of a comb, a simple straight comb. Now tell me, can it make a mirror half or not? Think over it. Yes, by putting a line in the middle of the comb, it will make a mirror half, which will look exactly the same of the other part. Okay, great going, children. Now let us take an example of a heart-shaped pillow. Do you know heart shape? Yes, I know that you know the heart shape. So think of a heart-shaped pillow. Imagine a heart-shaped pillow. Now tell me, can it be divided into two equal mirror halves? Think. Take some more time. Yes, it can be divided into two equal mirror halves. But how? Yes, by putting a standing line, it will become a mirror half image. Now, this is your home activity. You will have to find out the letters which cannot be divided into two equal mirror halves. Dear children, there are so many things around us which cannot be divided into two equal mirror halves, and many things that can be divided into two equal mirror halves. So, by using this mirror half quality, we can make many new things. In fact, we are using it. So, today we will make an animal mask activity by using this quality. For making a mask, you will need a piece of paper, a scissors, and some color. Now, we will make the mask of a cat. Take a piece of a paper, fold it along the middle. On one side, draw the half face of the cat, but be careful. We have to start drawing the face along with the folded side only. Now, we will cut it out using a pair of scissors. Now, open the fold and make eyes, nose, and other parts of the face. Color it and tie a rubber band on its back. Now our mask is ready. Meow! Wow, it was great fun. So children, this was all for today. Don't forget to find out the alphabets which cannot be divided into mirror halves. And one more thing to do at home, draw a half painting of a butterfly and show it to others. I'm sure that it will be a great fun. So, keep enjoying mathematics because it is full of magic. Dear children, with this episode, our Unit 1 of Math Magic Grade 3 is complete. We will meet again with one more new topic. Hope to meet you soon. Goodbye.
Friends, you are just listening to the series Dhwani Shala. Production assistant Kusum Lata. Recorded by Bati Langlingdo and Mayank Kumar. Produced by Vimlesh Chaudhary. And this program is brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.